Baby Frank learning to crawl for the first time. Look. Go on, off you go then. Call to Nanny. There he goes. Look. He's got all the way over there. Look. Good boy, baby Frank. Good boy. Oh, look who's just turned up, folks. Look. Unbelievable. What's he doing around here?
Hello there.
What are you doing?
I'm a cruising, man.
Where are you going?
I've been shopping.
Shopping? What, in this?
Yeah. Co-op. Sainsbury's.
Oh, yeah.
Sainsbury's, no bloody dear.
Sainsbury's dear? You want to cook your own food, mate?
I said, you want some Yorkshire tea bags.
Oh,
so
lovely.
Being a good boy, I went out and got some.
Did you?
So I thought I'd just take the old car out, like, you know.
Lovely, yeah.
Yeah.
Can you have a bit of a rev up, please?
It's not a rev up, it's got muffles. It's a muffler.
Oh, it does sound. It's a big engine. Might break down. I think he's broke down before, isn't he? Yeah.
I think it don't sound right now.
Nice, I like.
Bit of a mess in here.
Look at the state of his car, look. Look at the footwell, look. Unbelievable.
You got to have the drink.
Oh, you do like your coat, didn't you?
Yeah. I got my remote.
What's that for?
My radio.
Oh, yeah.
It's a long way to reach.
Is it? It's vibrating, it's throbbing.
Yeah, oh, well.
No, look, you, I mean.
Oh, me, yeah.
Not the car. Where are you going now, then?
On a quest.
Eh?
On a quest.
You're on a quest?
I'm on a quest.
They want to know when you're going to put another video out.
Well, I've been so busy painting girls and boys,
yeah.
Boys and girls,
yeah,
and going around seeing all these famous people. And
they don't know about that. I'll tell you later.
No, you won't. I'll have everyone stalking me.
All right. All right, I'm just going to have a little chat with him. I'll see you in a minute. Hey? Yeah.
Hello, people.
Hello, everybody. Look, we're just taking Nige for a walk. We're back in Lossimouth in Scotland, folks. And he's just covered me in crap. Look at me. Look, let him in the puddle over there, and he's covered me in rubbish. All over the place. Nigel, look, he's done that, and then he shook. Unbelievable. So yeah, folks, we took a drive up to Scotland after taking Sharon's car to the get a new couple of tyres on it. So we thought we'd come up here. We're up here for a few days now, but yeah, nice little break, and it's actually lovely and warm up here. I think it's about 17, 18 degrees at the moment. But Jimmy's at home, he's looking after the place, and obviously the two dogs as well. So yeah, there we are, back on the Lossiemouth beach. There's Sharon there, and just having a little scan round, folks. There's that Lossiemouth lighthouse, which is a bed and breakfast now, apparently, as we said before in one of our last videos. There's the caves we visited up there, and this is actually about a 45 minute walk from Tracy's house. We've walked all the way along there. What's he doing?
Get up!
I keep calling him Merlin. Nigel! Anyway. Just walking along here, folks. You don't see this very often. Look. Look at that. Look. In fact, has someone been in that? Oh, I'm not going to look inside. But yeah, you don't see that very often. Toilet in the middle of the blinking rockery. Look. Never seen that before. So nice just to get away. And the old Vauxhall Astra did the journey. An absolute treat, folks. Yeah, so. If you're watching my Retro Restore channel, you would have seen that we had to put two new tyres on the front of Sharon's car a couple of days ago. And that fault light did come back on, by the way, so it will be an oxygen sensor after the cat that needs changing. Jimmy's just phoned up, he's going to cut the grass. He bursts into life when we go away.
Gas and electric, Chris has got a note saying he's paying too much. He pays 103. They've asked him to reduce it to 73.
Unbelievable. With regards to the energy crisis that we got, folks.
Nice.
You know the hassle that I was having with Ovo, and them keep sending me bills after I've got about £800 in credit or whatever, and they keep trying to raise my direct debit. And anyway, I sent a letter off to their managing director. Anyway, I've accepted £75 as a payment. All they said they could give me was £5 for each phone call initially, so which I weren't happy with. But save going to the court and all that. I just accepted £75, and they said that they'll put me on the list, which the operator should have done, where I don't get notified for 3 months. Lo and behold, don't forget I was talking to the managing director's secretary or someone like that. A few days after that, I got another letter through, didn't I? So I sent a right snotty email, And she said, oh, it takes a couple of days to go through the system. I'm ever so sorry, blah, blah, blah. I said, well, if it happens again, I said, you'll be getting billed again. So anyway, that was that. So yeah, I took the payment. And to cut a long story short, folks, as you may know, we've been using the little Caligas cookers instead of using our large range hob, a gas cooker with 6 or 7 burners on it. And we've also had the air fryer, and my bills, I can now confirm, because a lot of people say, oh, they're quite expensive to run them air fryers, aren't they? Well, they might have a big element, but they're cooking a lot quicker, a lot faster, so you've got it on for less time. And my electricity bill in May this year, compared to May last year, is 13% lower, like for like. And my gas bill, listen to this one, since we've turned the boiler off and we're only cooking now on gas, I know we've got the boiler off because of the time of year, but the comparative from last year gas bill, May, to this May, we're 51% down on gas. There you go. And also, that £850 I had in credit is now up to £916 in credit. So I've even used less gas, which I told them I was going to do anyway. But yeah, so the little gas cooker seems to be a really great idea. And if we want to boil the kettle now, we don't put the electric on, we boil the kettle on the gas, and we picked up them gas canisters. You get 4 for £5, and we're getting them from B&M at the moment, which seems to be the cheapest place, but they will go up. We bought stacks of them anyway. So just to let you know on the update, those of you worried about the air fryer, it's lowered our bills, which we knew it would do, and now I've got the proof because I've just checked my gas and electricity usage over the last sort of year or so. Anyway, well, we're a bit further on, folks. I just wanted to show you this. Look, can you see these? Look, all these little things sticking up there. What it is, look, can you see the piles of spiral or spaghetti looking things? All them along there, look, we never saw them before, they weren't here, look. They're all lugworms, I think they're lugworms, means that they're under there. And these ones here with the holes, see right in the centre of the hole there, look, I don't know if you can see that, can you? There's a little hole there, and if you pour salt in there, you'd get a razor clam pop up. I think I did mention it in my last video, but last time we come, there was nowhere near as many as this. I know the tide's not long gone out, and that's probably why. Look, look at that, look. Nature, eh? So basically, you could catch, use the lugworms, dig down there, get the lugworms out to catch fish over in there, or you could just get some salt down there and directly around there, boof, dig, and a razor clam would pop up there, and you can eat them. They're like a long shell, that's what I call a razor clam, because it's like a long shell, like the old razors, the old fashioned razors. Yeah, so you could actually feed off the beach and live. If you had no food, you could scavenge the wildlife here and actually eat them. Look at Sharon standing amongst them, look. Here we go. Right, here we are, folks, here's Tracy again. You haven't seen her for a few weeks. And Sharon, obviously. She's straight into her pasty, look. I said for a wait, just to see what they taste like. Right, so we're in Elgin at the moment, folks. We just popped along to do a little bit of shopping. And a little bit of a historic town, I think, this one. And we've just been to Ashen's, the baker's. And Tracy's trying out, oh, Ashes, sorry. Ashes, the baker's in Elgin. And what have you got, the chicken and mushroom?
Mouthful of food right now.
Unbelievable.
I don't know, she said it was chicken and white sauce, didn't she?
Yeah, is it nice? She recommended that, didn't she?
Yeah.
And you went for what, baby?
Highland pasty.
Highland pasty, how did that differ from a normal pasty?
Don't know.
Does it taste the same?
I think it might be made higher up.
Yeah, there we go. And of course, we've got the old...
Highland beef, isn't it?
Iron brew. This is a sugar-free one, because we're not sugar eaters, baby, are we?
No.
And I've gone for, folks, a Scotch pie. Now, I've not had one of these since I was a kid at school, and if any of you don't know what they are, that's what they look like. It's pastry up the side. I think it's a water-based pastry.
Looks it, doesn't it?
Yeah, water crust on it. A thin water crust or something with a mince filling. And I used to get these when I was at school. Here we go. Mmm.
Can we see?
A savoury little number. Quite salty, actually, Tracy.
Is that?
Oh. Yeah, just as I remember them. And I also got a sneaky sausage roll. Oh, hello.
And a blowaway bag.
Well, I've got it, Tracy. Well, we are on our way, folks, so we're eating quite a few different things at the moment, so...
Well, that's not different, is it? A pasty?
No, they're Scotch pies, baby.
Yeah, baby.
So we'll see you in a minute. We'll have these, and then we'll have a little look around, see what we can find. There we go. This is Sharon having a look around Elgin. What's this, baby?
All different bits about Elgin.
Oh, right, okay.
Elgin toll booth there.
The courthouse and jail. Look, it once had a jail here, I suppose. Paying tolls and taxes.
What's this?
The Elgin toll booth, look.
Elgin Market here.
Council chamber, that building. I wonder where that is. It's disappeared. Let's have a look around this side.
Oh, yeah, I know. It's Royal Borough of Elgin.
Yeah.
See, they've got it in Braille there. Look.
Yeah.
Elgin High Street.
Yeah, so it's
there. Isn't it?
There's a big fountain there. I don't know whether that was for horses, maybe, or is it just a fountain of decoration? We've actually come to do a bit of shopping, folks. So Tracy needs to get a ballroom dress. She's going to a ball.
Ballroom gown, rather.
Let's have a little bimble.
Just
in an arcade, folks. Just looking in a window, and I come across this. You got all different sorts of games there and books and stuff. And then you got that one, Poo Bingo. I've never seen that before. A game designed around poo. There you go. This is what you don't see a lot now, local shops. It's normally big brands that are taking over all the shops, or they're all shutting down, but still plenty going on here in Elgin. Oh, hello. Little factoid, Tracy. Nuts? Yeah? See the nuts? What are they?
Cashew nuts.
Cashew nuts. Tell me a fact about them.
They're nice.
Yeah, but can you notice something different about them than all the other nuts we got there? Look.
Well, the shape.
No, well, not the shape. We got them white. Out of them ones.
They're not in the skin.
Out of them ones, them ones, and them ones.
They're not in the skin or a shell.
Yeah, and why is that?
Poisonous. Yeah, they are. The shell's poisonous.
That's right. You will never see them sold in this country in the shell.
Finished?
Yep. Mummy? I educate you, like, it's every time we come around shopping, don't we?
Oh, I bet it's a delight.
Hey?
I bet it's a delight.
She loves it. I like sparkling water, yeah. I think that might be down the next one. I like a lime one. Either that or elderflower, please.
This is tonic with elderflower.
Tonic?
Yeah.
Lovely.
It's
not
for you.
What?
It's not for you.
Not for me.
Do you want an elderflower tonic?
No, I'm not.
You can't really.
I just water stress it. Drive your mum. She's normally good at pulling plough, Tracy. Yeah?
Yeah,
what are you looking for here?
Oh,
that's not a proper breakfast, Tracy.
It's snack at school.
No, that's all sugar based.
No.
Hello?
Goodbye.
I'm just educating a shower.
Don't need to educate Tracy.
Everyone needs a little bit of education, baby. Okay. Sam, what are you going for?
Right,
oh, the kids will love them. Hey, baby, what do you think?
I prefer the ones next door, not the chocolate. I prefer the summer fruits.
Oh, James might like those.
Anything in a bright coloured box, folks, certainly make you buy it.
Oh, why didn't you go for the open light?
That's Tracy, anything in a bright coloured box?
I'm just a sucker.
Look at all these boxes.
George's.
All these boxes, look.
Blue's your brain, isn't it?
Well, the thing is that it's there to make you look and buy it. 9 times out of 10, when you open the box, it looks nothing like what it says on the box.
Oh, Kit Kat looks like Kit Kat.
Eh?
Kit Kat does look like a Kit Kat.
Yeah, but that's different, yeah. I'm talking about food. Yeah? Well, here, look. Open up that, look. Right? When you open that up, when does that ever... When does that even look like that, coming out like that?
Don't do chocolate spread.
Cook it yourself, baby, eh?
Oh,
all right. That's what we do now, Tracy. Tracy?
Yes?
We cook it ourselves.
Cook what yourself.
Eh? Food.
Food?
Yeah.
Yeah?
What you got there?
George's snack.
Snack again?
Oh, shut up. You have snacks.
Tuck, tuck, Sharon.
Amazing.
Cheesy base, yeah.
Nothing.
Not buttery.
Buttery biscuit base. Nanny, you got a funny hat on.
Oh, I know. It's good looking at them.
We're going out for a walk, aren't we?
Yeah.
Tracy.
Yeah.
You just tidied up everything.
Yeah, and I'm doing it again.
She tidied up this morning, folks, and now she's tidying up again about half hour later.
Yeah.
Right, Tracy, when we come back from our walk, we've got some interesting food to show the people, haven't we?
Mm.
Scottish fare.
Scottish.
Hello.
Hello.
What's that on your head?
This is the new fashion.
What is it called?
It's called...
Yeah. Toilet vision?
Toilet vision.
I like it.
No, it's called...
Benji, we've got some food, Scottish food to eat in a minute. Well, not when we come back off our walk.
Haggis.
Yeah, we've got this, look. Have you ever had it?
No, I haven't. I've had haggis.
Well, we've got haggis. We've also got... Now, I've seen this before.
No, I've seen it, but I've never had it.
Yeah, well, we've got that. And we've also got over here... Let's have a little look.
Apple juice piece.
We've got what you call... skinny.
I'm not skinny.
Yes.
Yeah, I thought this was Scottish breakfast.
It is Scottish. Where are you?
Scotland.
Right.
Scotland.
It's
Scotland.
What is it?
Scotland.
Hey, Mummy. Hello, Mummy's talking, sweet pea. Okay.
You talk to Ben.
Yeah.
What is it?
Beef steak square sausages.
Yep.
Two slices of black pudding.
Yep.
And two pork sausages. But they call them guys.
Ben, with your new fashion, can you tell your children to be quiet, please?
Quiet, please. Can I just say
In a minute.
You know what's happening? If you had won the other side, Ben, I'll take you a lot more serious.
Yes, I did look for one.
Never mind. I like it though.
It's good.
It's growing on me. Tracy?
So, yeah, the sausages, they don't call sausages, they call them pork links.
A pork link? Pork link?
No, it's a lawn sausage.
Not in a sausage shape, it isn't.
That is a lawn.
No, that's not.
Right, viewers.
Yeah, that's
question.
How can you take him seriously, Tracy?
It's beef, not pork.
Doesn't matter.
It makes a lot of difference to the pig or the cow.
You can actually hold your banana in your glasses.
It's a new thing, yeah? I like it. It's called packed lunch.
Yeah. Lunch on the go, I call it.
Yeah, how do you eat it, though?
You do this.
Unbelievable, folks. This bloke's a fool. Right. Oh, Ben, I've got a hack for you. Have you got a cable tie? I know you're good at cable tie.
I haven't got a cable tie.
Oh, you must have a cable tie.
Mr. Cable Tie.
But you used to fix the Vauxhall system with cable tie. Oh, you know your flat, your thing that falls down in the car? Cable tie it.
Yeah.
Listen, this is the bloke, folks. I didn't tell you before. This is the bloke, when we had the Vauxhall Signum, who fixed it, the water pipe, with
dodgy
not a Jubilee pipe. Clip. He tied a cable tie around
I didn't. I told you. That car was covered in tape.
Listen,
ties.
Listen.
Not from me.
It was you, Ben.
It wasn't.
The only other person that had it was your dad.
So you're blaming your dad?
No, it was to be in the garage.
You never took it to a garage, Ben?
No, he did. I never took it.
No, they don't do things like that, Ben.
They probably do. Quite
no. Anyway, can we go and have some fun now? Out, please.
Yes.
We'll see you outside, folks. We're on our way to have some fun. Take them stupid things off. Oh, you're taking it off.
Yeah. Keep them on.
What are you doing on a naughty step, baby?
Waiting for me to have a shower. I brought one of yours in and one of mine.
Oh, that's a silly thing to do, isn't it? Where are we actually going today? I've not asked you that question.
I think we're going to another part of Rose Isle. So woods we went
Rose
to
Isle.
Before.
What's Rose Isle?
The woods we went to before.
Where the woods is?
The woods, yeah.
Now, was that the place where the train track was?
Mm-hmm.
Right, so they've
but
seen
we're going
that.
For a different area.
Right, okay. So we're not going to show them the same stuff then?
No.
Say hello to Vijay, by the way.
Hi, Vijay.
How are you?
Script. How are you, VJ? What's the weather like in South Africa at the moment? Is it nice? What is it like? I don't know. I don't know what the weather's like there this time of year.
Anyway.
I'm not sure.
Thank you. Thank you, VJ.
Bye,
VJ. Get in, Nigel. Go on up. Nigel.
What is it? Who's got all this stuff in my clean car?
Oh, that's for you to take out, yeah.
Thanks, George.
Look, this is what I was talking about, folks. This, look. If he... He's lost the clip off of that, I think.
I haven't lost it.
Well, it's broken anyway, one of the two. But if you put a cable tie through that hole there, right, and then put it through there, that'll hold that in place. Look. God, that wind's strong, Ben.
It is, isn't it?
So that's what I suggest he does, because he's the king of working with cable ties.
Right, get these boxes.
Oh, yeah. While you're doing that, Shell,
yeah.
Can we just say happy birthday to Gary Cumberland's son, Liam?
Say.
It'll be 12 years old.
Happy birthday, Liam!
It'll be 12 tomorrow on Sunday the 12th. No, not the 12th, the 19th, sorry.
Yeah.
19th of June, isn't it?
Happy birthday, Liam. George, happy birthday to Liam.
Happy birthday, Liam.
Yeah, this will...
2 years older than you.
Shout. Yeah. Unfortunately, this would have to be the last happy birthday we do shout out, because we get so many people asking us to do. If we didn't stop it, then we'd be just doing 15 minutes of shout outs every week.
Would we?
Yeah. So, sorry people, but there you go, Liam. You are the last official one that we can shout out happy birthday to.
Happy birthday, Liam!
Say happy birthday again, George.
Happy birthday.
Say happy birthday to Liam. It's his last one. It's the last. It's not his last birthday. Oh, no, it's the last one we can do shout outs for.
That's sad.
I get so many people emailing me with, Cole, can you give me a shout out and all that? Ben? So many people, Ben.
Happy birthday, Liam.
It's Liam.
Happy birthday, Liam.
No one's interested in you.
12 tomorrow.
Happy birthday, Liam. Have a lovely day.
What? Say happy birthday to Liam.
What?
Happy birthday to Liam.
Say happy birthday to Liam.
Who's Liam?
Liam is a little
He's in there. He's in there. The camera. He's in there.
He watches Gangi on YouTube.
He watches Gangi like YouTube.
And he'd like you to say happy birthday to him.
Happy birthday.
He can't see you.
He says he can hear you.
Happy birthday.
No. Ems, it's Liam's birthday. Can you say happy birthday to Liam?
Happy birthday.
There you go, Liam. Happy birthday, my friend. Hope you had a lovely birthday. And that was all your dad's fault for getting your name with all these lunatics saying happy birthday to you.
Nigel.
Hello, mate. In the back of the old Vectra, look. Hello, you're in the front of the Vectra, aren't you?
Yeah, I'm the driver.
Yeah. Can you lead us the way, Benjamin?
Yeah.
Get in, Tracy.
Lock the door.
Hey, 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 hey.
Where's she going, Ben? You ain't putting her in the boot as well, are you?
Yeah, dog's in the boot.
Oh, unbelievable. Looks like I've got to go over here. Yeah. I'll keep my dog in the front, Ben.
No,
see you in a minute. Right, we're going, folks. We're going to make our way now to wherever they said we was going. We'll see you in a minute. This is the same place we've come to before. It's the same place, Ben.
Gangi, but there's a different route. There's a different route.
The journey here, did you get lost?
Oh, don't come out. He kept indicating to go one way and then turning the other way, folks. Just bugger me up a little bit.
Can I do some comedy?
Unbelievable.
Come on, Dad. Can I do some comedy?
In a minute, mate.
Hello.
Well, I don't know what I've done with it.
Well, I've probably left it on the roof or something.
You laughed at me when I lost my handbag yesterday. Yeah. Thank you, God.
So that's another thing I've bleaking lost then, isn't it?
Yep.
Yeah. Unbelievable.
Do you want to borrow my one?
Hey?
Do you want to borrow my one?
That's mine. Where is it? Where'd you get it?
You left it on the roof of the car.
Well, why didn't you tell me?
That wouldn't have been fun.
See what I have to put up with, folks?
All day.
He got me all confused, Ben. He got me all of a tither.
Take responsibility for your dementia.
Thank you. Thank you.
Yeah, Gangi.
Nursing home, next stop.
Shall? You could have told me, baby.
No.
Why?
You trying to mickey out of me mostly yesterday because I thought I'd
Yeah, oh, you got to hear this. What? When we was in Elgin yesterday. Yesterday.
Yeah, he was walking home from school.
Of course he was. I got the wrong place again, didn't I? How did she go, Sharon?
Walking home. Just bimbling, and she went,
I've lost my bag.
But it weren't her bag she had on her shoulder. It was, we walked little baby James to school, didn't we?
Yeah.
She had his rucksack. But in her head, she thought she had her bag on her. But it's the stance she done.
I knew you weren't on.
I'm just looking at the that hill there, Tracy, look.
Yeah.
And it makes you wonder, that hill there, it's higher than the rest of the ground. Look.
The hills generally are.
Yeah, well, the point I'm making is, I reckon that this was a natural water way,
maybe.
But down there, and the land was probably a bit higher up there, maybe? What do you reckon?
Maybe, yes. Good theory. Maybe
See?
From that water tank. That you're convinced is a World War II bunker.
It is a bunker, Sharon.
Look,
and the water would run, because water, Tracy, always runs downhill.
No.
Yeah, then,
yes. But funny thing is, all the water, Tracy, is down there, at the bottom of the hill.
Yeah, it is.
So if it was all downhill, the sea, where would the water come from uphill?
Yeah, that's what Grandad's saying. It can't come up, can it?
Can't come up. Oh, hello. I've dropped it again, folks. Look.
Oh, my goodness.
No, throw it on Nanny's head.
Tell an adult that, should you?
Hey, that'd be the next thing he does. I know what he's like, Sharon.
Tracy.
Where is Em? Oh, hello. Nanny's undoing her boots. Look, she's going to run with her feet in the sand. Look.
She has walking boots.
Come, Grandad.
Finally, she has walking boots.
What are you doing, Sharon? Come, Grandad. Baby, what are you doing?
Looking for a bag.
Get out.
Ride him, cowboy.
Don't yourself.
Unbelievable.
No, it's up to that bloody... Park when I went along then.
No, I love you, Gangi.
I love you. Avengers, assemble!
Little walk in
Avengers,
the woods.
Assemble! Avengers, assemble!
Right, we've found a little a bit of an obstacle here, baby, haven't we?
What a swing. I want to see
Mum go. Look. Right up there, look. Go on, baby, up you go, baby. Go on, Shell. You can do it. Hard work walking up in this soft sand, folks, I'll give you that. You take one step forward and two steps back. You having a go? Look at that tree, folks, look. Look at it, look. Wow, that's a bit dangerous.
It is, it's fun. It's so sad.
Go on, Shell. He's off.
Go on, Shell, you're okay.
You having a go, Tracy?
I have to stop.
No, I'm just hot.
It's very hot.
It's a bit warm.
Hot. It's a bit warm, actually.
Oh, James.
I'd take your weight. Look, look at him, look. Unbelievable. You not having a go, Tracy?
Yeah, thanks
very much. We'll stay up here and watch from above, baby.
Yeah, we're staying with Lassie.
Yeah, we got... No, run, Joe, run, Shell.
Yeah, he's watching her, look. Go, buddy. She goes well up, doesn't she?
Yeah. Remember these things, folks, in the last video, I thought they were trees. They're all dotted out there, as you can see. But you actually found out what they were, Ben,
yes,
didn't you?
They are.
So, they were to prevent gliders from landing on the beach back in the wartime. There you go. Hello.
Hello.
Doing some home maintenance.
Yeah.
Call that a lawnmower.
That's all we need.
I like a lawnmower with a proper engine on it, folks. None of this electric motor with cord stuff on it. Lovely job. Like a professional, look at him, look. Like a lawn care guy. Like a lawn care guy you are.
Yeah, I am.
Do a lovely job. Little Rosie the cat there, look. That's one of the Cyprus cats, folks. Oh, hello, what's these, what's that on there, I just noticed, Ben? What's this?
Oh, I don't know what that is.
Now, that's a common thing, folks, you see, on electric lawnmowers, Ben. Yeah? Yeah?
I think that was your son, actually.
What?
Jimmy.
What?
When I was away on detachment,
yep.
He cut the grass for trace.
And he done that?
And went over it twice, I think, yeah.
It's a common thing.
It is.
And there should be an RCD on that, but that's another story.
I haven't unwound it all either.
Oh my God. I'm going to leave you to it, Ben.
Life on the edge, I do.
I'm going to prepare our cooking video, our taste test. Scottish sausages.
Lawn care.
Right, folks, so these are two of the things I'm going to be cooking up, well, heating up rather. We've got this white pudding here, which I gather is a common occurrence in chip shops up here in Scotland. And if you can see the ingredients there, it's only got a couple of main ingredients. It's oatmeal and beef fat. It says UK there, so I presume the beef fat is coming sourced from the UK. Onion, water, salt and pepper, and that's all you've got. And then we've got this Hall's traditional haggis as well, which we've got as well. And again, you can microwave this one in 6 minutes. The main ingredient, as you can see there, is pork lungs. Oatmeal, pork fat, pork liver. It's basically a pork meal. There's the nutritional information. So we'll be trying that as well. What do you want? What do you want? A bag?
Yeah. Have a side, I think.
What bag do you want?
Three bags.
Yeah. Little black bags?
Yeah,
that'd
be fine, maybe.
There you go, Benji. I'm just doing some cooking.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, see you in a minute. There we go. We'll just get that on, folks, like that. And let's just start off. We'll open up this breakfast pack, which, to be honest with you, is still a little bit frozen. There we go. We just put them in there. Yeah, should have unfroze this, I think. A couple of sausages, or links as they're known. So they're the links. That's called the loam. Is it loam, Tracy?
Yes.
They're the loam sausage.
Loin.
Loin. Loam. And that's the black pudding. Right, so I've just taken the white puddings out of their cases. So that is literally them. It's oats and fat by the looks of it. So they've got to be microwaved. So we're just having a look now at this traditional haggis, which apparently we've got to take out of the outer skin as well. So that's that, folks. Look, start to cut through it. Here we go. That is the skin. No, that's it now. That's it. No, that was it. So that's it, folks. So the main ingredient of that is pork lungs. Yeah? So we'll get a plate. Let's get rid of this. Right. Now, I suppose we put that on there like that, folks. I don't know. If we leave them on there like that, and then we'll have to possibly cut them open and check them. So let's put them in the microwave now for about 3 minutes, and we'll see how we get on. Right, I'd actually left the beaten surround on the black pudding, folks, so I better take it out and take it back off again. Right, that's nearly done, folks. I think I'm going to crack an egg in there as well, but I've just pulled the white pudding out of the microwave. Sharon's just taken one look at it and said, I don't like the look of that. So that's that. Anyway, let's put an egg in there. Right, sorry about the noise, folks, because it's a house full of kids, unfortunately, but let's just crack that in there. Another one in there as well. There we go. Let's get them cooking down, folks. And then we'll dish out the taste test. So, here we go. We've got the three items in front of us. We've got the white pudding there, which, again, is just turned to I don't know what.
Sausages!
We've got the Scottish breakfast, which consists of pork links, which are the normal sausages. The flat loam, is it loam, Tracy?
Loin loams,
whatever. And then we've got the haggis. Oh. Right, so we'll start off with this first, because I think you want to get that one over with first.
Yeah, I want to eat it.
Right, right.
You want to eat some?
Yeah, yeah, then.
Right, you've got two forks there, Tracy. Right, see what you think of it first. Have a go at that. Tell us what you think of it.
It might be hot.
Oh.
Eat it.
I like it.
Well, James?
It's actually better than what it looks.
Have you just had a bit? Mm. Tracy?
Oh.
It reminds me of something.
Oh.
Cheese and onion pasty.
Some more.
Yes.
It reminds you of what?
Cheese and onion pasty. Come on, Bims.
Ew.
Some more?
He just spat it out. Like it. He just spat it out, Shell. How's that, George?
I hate it.
It's good.
Is it okay? Right, okay. Right, let me have a little go of it. Let me get a bit on the knife here. Hold on.
I want the sausage in
after. Hold on, let me have it. If I'm going to have a bit, I want a proper bit.
Sausages.
Hold on. That's actually not too bad.
It looks
cheese and onion
pasty,
isn't it?
No,
it does taste like a cheese and onion pasty.
I want the sausage.
That's quite tasty. Right, so what's your points for that then? Do you like that? Out of 10.
I like it. No,
six.
I
would
say 7.
7.5.
Right. Sharon?
6.
I'll probably give it a 7 out of 10. It's quite, it's tasty.
I think 7 out of 100.
Oh, jeez.
Well?
It's good. I don't like the texture.
Yeah, well, that's the oats. All it is, oats and fat, pork fat. That's
it's
all
quite
it is.
Strong.
Right, so, next bit we got is the
sausages.
I'll tell you what, we do the haggis next. Pull that one out of the way.
Oh, no. Sausage,
yeah, you can have the sausage in a minute. Right, Tracy, dish a bit of that out to your children and Nanny.
Only a little bit.
Cut it through to the middle where it's hot. Get a good taste of it.
You ready, George? Give it a blow.
Oh, Barbie.
Go on in. That is what you call haggis.
That's amazing.
You like that?
Let me try.
Go on in.
What does it taste like?
It's quite nice. The last time
reminds me of black pudding.
Yeah, a little bit. The last time I had it, it was lovely.
It reminds me of sausages.
Black sausages.
Black sausages, come on.
I'm coming.
So, let me just taste a bit of it first. Let's have a go.
Don't shout.
It's okay.
What have I got in next to me?
Bah!
It's a similar texture as the white pudding. Obviously made with oats. But because the black pudding, the haggis, has got pork lungs in it, that's where you're getting your meat from, your flavour. And Tracy, what do you think about the haggis?
It needs something with like a gravy or something.
You can.
Faggots, that's what it is, faggots.
Yes. Yeah.
Faggots.
Well, it tastes like faggots.
Yeah.
Yeah.
When you said the gravy, I could then picture any faggots.
Yeah.
0-0.
So, how many points out of 10 for the haggis?
I'd give that 6 as well. It does, as Tracy said, it needs gravy, and then that could give it an extra.
You'd normally have it with tatties and neeps.
Tatties and neeps.
Turnips, isn't it?
Oh, we can make this and
then. Right, okay. Now, the bit you probably want to get involved
sausages,
with is the breakfast. Cut them into little bits of chunks. Try the sausage first, Tracy,
sausage
if you want.
Who wants some sausage?
They're called links, actually, so...
Emily?
Sausage? Is it a Scottish one, or is it English?
Yeah, it's called a link in Scotland.
Yeah.
So you can taste a bit of that. Nanny? And a bit for James?
The ones in South Cyprus.
James, try that. Now, what you tell me what you think of that. That's a pork's link.
It just reminds me of the sausages in Cyprus that we used on the bike.
Mummy, can I have a bit, Nanny? Mummy,
ten out of
6. Can I try a bit?
10 out of 6.
10 out of 6.
10 out of 10.
So, I'm just going to have a go at this.
Is it good?
It's bland.
It's a pork sausage, just same as the English sausage.
Obviously.
The one which might be a little bit different is going to be this flat... Is it a link loam? What is it, Ben?
Lawn.
Lawn. Oh, it's a lawn, folks. It's called a lawn. Funny enough, we're eating the lawn in here, Tracy, and Ben's doing the lawn out there.
Hey, James.
Home of thrones.
This should probably maybe be like a burger, James.
So probably like a pork burger, yeah.
It's actually better than a sausage.
Can I have a go, Tracy?
Oh, yeah, sorry.
Can't wait until the egg. The egg will be my best.
You don't get the flavour straight away, do you?
No, but I think it's better than the sausage.
This is good.
There's more meat in it, yeah. Good. And the final thing is a little bit of black pudding.
Oh, black pudding.
And the egg.
Well you can have the egg anyway. Well, you know what the egg's like. That don't come out of the same breakfast pack.
No, it's a different egg.
No, it's a normal egg.
I just want to try the egg. You don't like the egg?
Good boy, George.
Right, let's have a bit of that.
Just having a
black pudding. It's a nice black pudding, yeah, actually, isn't it?
So you like the white pudding and the black pudding?
So, right, out of all that... Oh, what's that, Tracy?
That's good.
That's
good.
You don't like black pudding?
That's good.
James,
that's good.
Stop shouting.
Don't
swear. We're going, so what was our favourite out of all that?
Gosh, that's tough. Yeah, I think maybe...
The white pudding?
Yeah.
Now, that does surprise me.
If that was in gravy, then it would probably be the haggis.
Right. James, George, what about you? What was your favourite? Do you like the white pudding at all? Sharon?
The square sausage.
You preferred the square sausage? I preferred the black pudding, to be honest with you. I thought that was a nice black pudding.
That's horrible.
I like sausage.
Yeah. Anyway, folks, there you go. I don't know if they're going to eat that, to be honest with you. I think George might eat the white pudding, but you can have the egg, Emily. That's fine.
Oh, yeah.
Take an egg, George. Put an egg on there as well. Which basically means now that I've got no breakfast. Hey. I just ate all my breakfast.
I bet in somewhere.
I'm hungry, baby. We've just come back from a 3-mile walk. Anyway, thanks very much, folks. Hope you've enjoyed this little vlog. Don't forget to check out our other videos and just have a look what we get up to during the week. We do 3 cooking videos on a Monday, Wednesday and a Friday. They go out at 2 o'clock. 3 o'clock in the afternoon, Sharon. Sharon.
I don't know what time.
3 o'clock in the afternoon, baby.
I thought it was 2.
And on the Sunday, you can join us on our premiere, which is 8 o'clock in the evening, where we've got the live chat box, where hopefully, on this video, you're chatting to us in the chat box. Anyway, thanks very much, folks. We'll be back to normal next week. Well, are we ever going to be back to normal?
No.
So we'll see you in the next video, and until then, bye for now.
Bye!
Bye for now! Bye!
You're so bloody loud.